This week's lab will introduce you to musical scales. You'll learn that to what scale and to what frequency each note is tuned in a piano. And you'll be able to understand as to why the piano has a specific arrangement of black and white keys. The piano has a series of strings with varying thickness and tension. The tension in each steel string is such that sound of a specific frequency is obtained when a padded hammer strikes it. In this lab, you'll use an electronic keyboard whose notes can be tuned to specific frequencies by using a keyboard controller. You will be able to hear the notes from the speaker and read off the frequency of the sound generated from the frequency counter. The oscilloscope will display the waveform of the signal generated from the keyboard. A musical scale is a sequence of frequencies and is normally contained in an octave. There are 7 intervals between the white keys within an octave. The keyboard controller has knobs which can be used to tune one octave. Each key within an octave can be tuned separately. As you tune one octave, the other octaves are tuned automatically. The keyboard that you'll be using has 4 octaves, with frequency of each note doubling as you move from one octave to the next one. For example, there are 4 C's on the keyboard. The leftmost C, when played, has a frequency of 120 Hz. The second C has a frequency of 240 Hz, and so on. Thus, you can see that the frequency doubles as you jump an octave. For the first part of the lab, we will tune the keyboard to the just scale. We will do this by tuning the 3 triads, the first of which is C, E, and G. This can be done by tuning the keys to the ratio 4:5:6. Before you begin tuning the triad, recall what intervals are. A musical interval is characterized by the ratio of 2 frequencies. The interval sounds the same if they have the same frequency ratio. If an interval has a frequency ratio of 2:1, then it is called an octave. And you can remember that by numbering the white key starting with C until you get to the next C. Similarly, a frequency ratio of 3:2 is called a fifth. In this case, the C and G form a fifth. Major third is 5:4 and minor third is 6:5. Now we will begin tuning the first triad. Tune the second C key from the left to a frequency of 240 Hz. Then tune E and G such that the ratio of C, E, and G is 4:5:6. Now, if the triad is not in perfect ratio, and if you play C and E and G together, then you'll hear beats and you can see them on the oscilloscope. After this, build another triad starting on G, that is G, B, and upper D. Again, the frequency should be in the ratio of 4:5:6. Finally, make a third triad which ends on upper C, that is F, A, upper C, with the same ratio of 4:5:6. You have now obtained a just scale. So far, you have only experimented with 3 triads, but if you want to play a triad starting on E, you cannot only use the white keys. For this, you can tune the black key to the right of G, which is called G sharp or A flat. Once you tune that, you can now get a triad E, G sharp, B, which again has the ratio of 4:5:6. If you now calculate the ratios of adjacent frequencies, you will be able to see a pattern. The interval which has a black key in between, also called whole tone, has a change of either 12.5 or 11.1%, whereas the interval which does not have a black key in between is called half a tone, and the interval change is 6.7%. This is about half of the larger interval. Next, you will tune the tempered scale. This scale is divided into 12 exactly equal half tone intervals. To get an octave after 12 semitones, the frequency ratio of a semitone must be 12th root of 2. Next, we come to transposition. If you play the white key starting on C, you're playing the C major scale. The major scale is characterized by the following sequence of intervals. Similarly, if you play the white key starting on A rather than C, you obtain the following sequence of intervals, which is called a minor scale.